Radio legend Neil Mitchell says it's been a privilege and a delight to spend the past 34 years on Melbourne's morning airwaves. He dedicated his final program to his listeners, thanking them for their patience, trust and help. His longtime former producer, Heidi Murphy, has this report.
Making his pre-dawn trek to the office one last time, and it may be 5 a.m, but the phone is already ringing. No resting for this 72-year-old.
But you arrive at virtually the same time, well, at least as me. What's your sleep like?
Lousy. I was awake at 2:30 today.
Nervous, perhaps, about the day ahead in the glare of the spotlight on his final morning radio shift after 34 years.
Yes, good morning. This is it. Final day.
Kicking off with an ominous caveat.
And I should warn you, I haven't had much sleep, so I'm a bit dangerous.
A heads up his first guest might have wanted.
Mr. Albanese, good morning.
Good morning, Neil.
For a broadcaster who's made an art form out of grilling politicians, there was to be no softening for the last day.
The polls are bad, the government's stumbling, you look tired, you could be chopped liver as well. What are you doing wrong?
I'm absolutely fine, Neil. It's been a difficult time.
The Premier's well wishes were sent from afar.
I wish him also all the very best for the future.
Her deputy becoming the first Victorian minister in 18 months to brave the studio.
Look, seriously, thank you for coming in.
I first listened to you in 1993 when I was at home waiting for my VCE Year 12 results.
As for what he's waiting for now...
You still like to be Premier one day?
That's not what I'm focused on.
It wouldn't be live radio without a few hiccups.
Good grief. Oh, yes, come on. This is a trick you've played for years. You always come in late.
Former footy boss Gillon McLachlan turning the tables.
How are you feeling about leaving something that's been so big and so important to you?
There's a bit of trepidation, of course.
That feeling echoed by the guests that Neil would consider most important, his listeners.
What? I am terrified. I've wanted to do this for 30-odd years. So many times I've rang and, I've hung up.
You've made me laugh. You've made me cry. You've made me swear at you.
This young caller was just looking for a favour.
Hi, Neil. Before you finish up on the radio, do you think you could convince my mum to buy me a puppy?
After nearly 27,000 hours of morning radio over more than three decades, it is now down to this, the final hour, and a final farewell to those who've stuck by him.
You, the audience, make talk radio hum, and you've done that for me. Thank you for listening. Thank you for talking. Thank you for caring. Thank you for trusting. Thank you for having a go and helping us to have a go. Thank you for being there. Take care.
With the flick of a switch, it was done.
Bloody hell, what's going on here?
Colleagues, past and present, lining up to salute this former newspaper man who accidentally became the voice of Melbourne for generations. Heidi Murphy, Nine News.